Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? I'm going to do a reaction video on this video here. I have a lot of things to say about it, but I want to find out what Yosky and Athena have to say about the subject. And I encourage you to go check this video out. There's a link below. And I'm just going to do a little commentary to introduce you to these Pleiadian, Tibetan Pleiadian girls who are sharing information with planet Earth. Anybody who will listen. Okay, here we go.
Originally in Spanish, February 2023.
Hello, Yazzie. Is there anything new with all of the fuss about shot down UFOs? Is it more of a distraction, or is there clearly an agenda?
It's still early, but the Tibetans from their CIC feel it could be part of the fake alien invasion agenda. Because as far as real ET movements, again, as I was telling you last week, nothing is happening.
The first time I heard about the fake alien invasion scenario was about 10 years ago, I think. The idea being that if you can scare up the people enough to agree to give up their rights, the solution to an outside scare like that would be to unite as a one world united. And this would mean more things similar to the UN and the EU and all this stuff, getting together even more under the control of one militaristic government for the good of all. But it would be a fake invasion to scare people into giving up more of their freedoms. That's how they do it. That's a strategy. That's how it's done. Anyway, let's continue.
Smells of cabal manipulation and agendas.
Yeah.
There is a lot of fuss over the net with the news that the USA and Canada shot down ET craft.
Okay. If they're actually saying, I haven't heard any news, I don't listen to the news, but if they're saying shot down ET, extraterrestrial craft, you know they're trying to warm up the population of the planet to the idea that there's extraterrestrials. First, we'll start with extraterrestrial. Then we'll discuss agenda of extraterrestrial later. But it's all story, right? It's all story to get the people to believe in something. So I'm saying, okay, get ready for a setup. And I think the more people know about the idea of a fake alien invasion, with the understanding that the reasoning behind it would be to further us acquiesce and agree to give up our certain rights as nations, for example, and our liberties and freedoms that are ours under our bylaws of our countries, give up some of those rights, just a little bit at a time, a little agreement here and there, and say, oh, okay, let's get united. And so instead of the U.S. government, this would be my theory, instead of the U.S. government being in control of what's important to the U.S., now the U.S. government would be deferring to the world government, so to speak. This is just some theories about how it may be trying to see if they can get it to work.
And since they are giving it a lot of media attention, we know it is something they are plotting. Or else they would silence the news. They would not broadcast it.
That's a good point, you guys. Yeah. If they're, I mean, they got years and years, 50, 60, 70 years of suppressing this kind of news. Why would they all of a sudden start leaking it out unless they wanted it leaked out or put on the air?
So we conclude that it is something they want people to think.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing extraterrestrial, at least, was shut down. Vieira traffic control indicates all quiet in the region.
This is the, if you're not familiar with this, the extraterrestrial, the good guys out there, Andromedans, the Pleiadians from the Gaia star system and others. They are monitoring our airspace. And these Tibetan ETs here that are talking here have been communicating for several years now through the Cosmic Agency YouTube channel with Gosha and Robert. And there's tons of information that they've been sharing. And go over there, check it out. You know, it really resonates with me. And get the full picture, the backstory, so to speak, what's been going on and what is going on now regarding our planet from an extraterrestrial point of view, from human beings, these Pleiadian, and human beings that care. All right? Anyway, let's go.
The hoax, or the mess, is coming from Earth. Oh, and about the ISS, supposedly publishing shots of spherical craft. It's there, but it's not the size they tell you, nor does it serve what they tell you. And since its mission is classified, no. I repeat, they would not give the people tracking. It is a cover to hide ETs. They edit everything that really comes from the ISS. So what they show is because they want people to believe that. It's all manipulated. Nothing official at any level is real information.
This has been going on for years and years and years. It's once you understand how the cabal works, you'll understand, you know, this makes sense.
Everything is manipulated in order to control the perception of the greater public.
And the reason they want to control the perception of the greater public has to do with how reality is created. And there's a consensus reality on Earth. The way things are the way they are by virtue of what people think and feel and manifest through their beliefs and agreements and considerations of what reality is. And if the regressive ETs can manipulate our perception of what we see, then we'll have other conclusions. We think we're looking at one thing, and it's a hoax, but we think it's the legitimate deal, and so that's our perception being messed with. And now we're going to have thoughts and considerations about what we're seeing, and then we're going to be afraid of or being in fear of alien invasion or something like this. And they like to manipulate us through fear. And our fear-based reality is being manifested. If you got enough people being afraid of something and considering something to be real, it becomes real. It becomes the reality of the population. So that's how that works. Dog needs to come in. Come on, big boy. Okay.
Do not, I repeat, I do not have any record of any drone nor any craft of non-human origin shut down in the last days or even years. Humans make up their own stuff and pursue their own inventions.
Yeah, yeah.
It all smells like a fake alien invasion.
Yeah, and it's not like it would be the first time we got bamboozled. Something happened and, you know, the news about what happened was different from what actually happened. Pay attention, people.
There are always real drones, and have been since the beginning of time. whatever that means. Just that from here, I have no evidence of unusually high drone traffic.
And I think from here she means from orbit around Earth, where they monitor the drones and all of that. Okay?
Toleka is in low orbit. Everything that comes in and out of Earth, Toleka and CIC's AI finds out.
Toleka is their spacecraft.
But why would the aliens come if they don't exist for humanity?
Although it seems contradictory, everything indicates that the Cabal is preparing something along the lines of a fake alien invasion to force humanity to unite against an external threat and thus implement the New World Order. With restrictions and with injected digital identifiers or whatever, so as to be able to distinguish between humans and infiltrating ETs. And this part, unfortunately, is true, because so many step-downs are already driving the Cabal crazy. Even so...
A step-down is an ET that has stepped down into our population. Basically, there's other videos about what a step down is and a walk in, and all that over at Cosmic Agency YouTube channel.
I do not predict that they will do it. It is one of many agendas that they always have, and they go forward little by little with all of them to gradually see which of their agendas best suits the situation of the moment.
Yeah, it's like, you know, they throw shit at the wall and see what sticks and see what the population is going to buy. So if they get too much feedback or pushback, oh, this is bullshit, man. This is a false invasion. This is crap. Look out for false invasions, this sort of thing. If they get enough for that kind of pushback on the social medias and different places and ways, then they go, oh, this ain't working. Let's try something else. Well, we started this other thing over here. Let's see how that's going. Yeah, let's try that because this shit ain't working. It's kind of like that. I could work myself up into a nice angry rant if I'm not careful.
I also feel that they are experiments, these things or these alien incidents. They remain semi-forgotten until the next thing that they will also provoke and control.
Okay, yeah, so, hey, this is about one-third through the video. I haven't watched the rest myself, but I wanted to keep this short as an introduction to the Cosmic Agency YouTube channel and swaru.org website, where these Tegetan ETs communicate in real time through text chat to Gosha, mainly to Gosha and Robert. And go over and check it out for yourself, the legitimacy and the value of the information will be yours to judge, okay? But some of the best stuff I've seen is the best stuff I've seen and found in over 50 years of spiritual development and, you know, checking into UFOs and ETs and alien agenda and all that stuff. Actually, I have a YouTube channel called Alien Agenda 101. I put together about 10 years ago. I never really used it. I kind of ended up with this YouTube channel instead. But yeah, thank you for watching, and your comments are welcome. But this is just a go watch the video kind of reaction video, or a quick update for people that are brand new to the whole subject. Okay? All right. Take care now. Bye-bye.